everyone, namaste. Myself Kabindra Karna. Welcome to the new episode of the Global Medical and the Pharmacy Updates. Let's check it out what happened in the last week. The first update is coming from the US FDA, where the US FDA has given the two draft guidance for the investigational product for the developers, where now they can go through it as per this guidance through that investigational drug to find out the drug-drug interaction. So this is really nice to reduce the complication of the medication, or you can say the drug complication of the medication, and increase the therapeutic efficacy. And this has been done under when the drug is under the investigation only, where they have given the two drafts, where the one document says that it will be based on the FDA recommendations as per the labeling, the time of interaction occur, the detail interpretation of that particular interaction. Where in the same time another document they have given, where in that document it has completely focused on the in vitro strategies of the particular drug, how it occurs and in which condition, different mechanism of action, enzyme like which enzyme cause this interaction, like in detail mechanism they will study in this. Another update is also coming from the US FDA, where the US FDA has approved the new formulation for the type 2 diabetes mellitus medication, which is extended release suspension, that is bidurinobicasi, in diabetes in which the uncontrolled level sugar is there after giving the medication. Also in such kind of cases, this has been injected through the auto-injector device. Continuous release microscopy delivery system give, or we can say provide, consistent therapeutic level of the active ingredient. Another update is also coming from the FDA, where the FDA has promoted the biosimilar use, where they has gone through the one campaign to educate the physician to use of the biosimilar products, where they have done one educational campaign on October 23, 2017, where they have described about the biosimilar definition and the different FDA guidelines they have to go through. And this is really nice. So let's see what will be the more updates on this in the upcoming future. Another update is coming from the World Health Organization, that is WHO, where the WHO has given the one report where it says that 7,000 newborn babies die every day. Is according to them, in between the 2017 to 2030, in the future, it will occur more than 30 million of the newborn baby will die in their first 28 days. Where they have also shown the report of the 2016, where it has been seen that 15,000 of the children has been died before their fifth birthday, and the 46%, that is the 7,000 children, has died within their first 28 days. So this is really sad, and they have said that this is mostly happen in the South Asia and Sub-Saharan Africa. And the report is coming from the UNICEF, where they said that they have saved 50 million children since 2002. UNICEF comes under the WHO, so this is really nice, and they have given both the data. This money will be die, and means currently dying, in future this will be the data which will come. So they are trying their best what they can do in saving the newborn baby lives. Can you guess unhealthiest countries in the world? I mean, really, can you guess? So here is one report given by the UK, which has been taken from the World Health Organization. And they have published the unhealthiest country in the world, where the Russia also taken the place in those countries, which is continue with Slovenia, Slovakia, Hungary, Poland, and the many other countries also, in which Afghanistan is the least unhealthiest country, which also continues with Nepal, Nigeria, and Congo. And this data has been given in the basis of the different parameters of the different country, where they have taken the three main parameters: alcohol consumption, tobacco consumption by the people, and the weight prevalence, or we can say the obesity in the population, they have taken into the study. Then after they have given this report of the unhealthiest country. Another update is coming from the Abbott, where the Abbott has given the one new kind of device, which has been approved by the FDA also, that device is insertable cardiac monitor. This will be inserted into your skin of the chest and it will give the completely all the detail of your heart, like either the arrhythmia conditions and many other cardiac details, on your smartphone also, on your computer also, which is My Medline mobile app. So this is really nice, and this is good to track the patient health condition also by the doctors, and the patient also can see the different parameters in their mobile or in the computers. So guys, only this much for today. Hope you like the episode, and thank you so much for giving your valuable time. Take care, have a great night.